Hello everyone and welcome in to Coach Craig Sports. This is the MLB DFS Core Pick video for today, Friday, July 5th. If you're joining me for the very first time, first of all, welcome in. Second of all, this is how today's video will be structured. We will not be having a recap since it's been quite a while since I did make a video or a live stream. So do apologize for that once again. Been pretty sick this week, still kind of sick at this point in time. But with that being said, we'll start off with the weather report, highlight any games that do have a double-digit chance of rain. After that, we'll get moved over to FanDuel, talk about my core picks, which is going to be five players. It's going to be one pitcher, four hitters. It's going to be based on a combination of past performance versus the respective opponent, as well as some recent history. And then after that, we'll get moved over to my cheat sheet and talk about my top GPP teams to stack for tonight's slate overall. But without further ado, we'll get started with that weather report for today. So we got five games that we're going to talk about in total that do have a double-digit chance of rain or higher, with kind of varying levels of whether or not I think they'll ultimately end up going off. We'll start out in New York with the Yankees and the Red Sox, 32% chance of rain, definitely one that we'll monitor as the day moves along. We'll keep a close eye on that one. And then we move over to Cleveland, where we have the Guardians and the San Francisco Giants, 39% chance of rain there, so that's definitely one that we'll be keeping an eye on as well. For our other game out in Ohio, we have the Cincinnati Reds and the Detroit Tigers, 26% chance of rain there. And then we move down to Atlanta, where there is a 64% chance of rain for that Braves and Phillies game, so that's probably going to look like the most sketchy one in terms of whether or not it'll ultimately end up going off or not tonight. So that's going to be one that we'll have probably the closest eye on, although I do like some of the players in this game overall. And then lastly, in Minnesota, we have the Twins and the Astros. So this is the game that is most likely to go off, but it has an 18% chance of rain, so we'll highlight it for this part of the, but do ultimately expect that this game does end up getting played. But with that being said, that's a quick little rundown on the weather report for today. We'll get moved over to FanDuel and talk about my core picks. So we're going to start off at the pitcher position with Pablo Lopez, $10,300. A lot of good pitchers on tonight's slate, so feel free to mix and match as you do see fit. Pablo Lopez pitching a little bit better as of late. He's averaging about 32 fantasy points per game on the season. He has some pretty decent history versus Houston Astros in the past, although it is some limited history. He had 46 points versus Houston earlier this season, did not pitch against them in 2023. If we look at what he's done so far in the season, been a little bit of a hit or miss year. 8 wins, a 4.88 ERA, so his problem has mainly been the home runs so far this season. Pitching in Minnesota tonight with maybe a little bit of questionable weather, might be a little bit better for him than pitching, you know, like down in Houston or something like that, but definitely do like his upside tonight. And then, like I said, if you look at what he's done lately, the last two starts have been really good for him. The one before that was pretty rough. So it's been a really up and down year for him, but definitely do like the upside that he does present for tonight's slate overall. Then we're going to move down to catcher Cal Raleigh at $2,800, averaging about 9 fantasy points per game on the season. He goes against the Toronto Blue Jays and Kevin Gausman on the mound tonight. He's 3-for-7 with 3 home runs in his career versus Kevin Gausman, so I do like the upside that's there. He's a reasonable price guy. If you don't want to play him, definitely does make some sense. If you look at what he's done so far in the season, he's below the Mendoza line now. He's at that 198 average, 15 home runs, 51 RBIs. So he's been pretty productive in the hits that he does get. The problem is he just doesn't get a lot of hit. There is a lot of swing and miss to his game. 6 out of his last 9 games, though, he has at least 1 hit. 0 multi-hit games during that time span, though. So that's kind of the downside with him. He has 3 home runs during that time span, though, as well as 4 double-digit performances. So the games that he does go out there and he performs well, he does ultimately end up paying off at this price tag. He's got that good history versus Kevin Gausman in the past. You know, maybe it's a little bit riskier play. If you don't like it, obviously you can switch to somebody else, but does look like a pretty good value spot for him overall tonight. Then we're going to move over to third base with Austin Riley. So once again, this game does have the biggest question mark in terms of weather, so keep an eye on that as the day moves along. $3,500, averaging under 10 fantasy points per game on the season now. But he goes against the Phillies tonight. It's Aaron Nola on the mound. He's hit Aaron Nola really well throughout his career. He is 21-for-54 with 5 home runs versus Aaron Nola, so that is some really good history there. Arguably the best on tonight's slate overall. If you look at what he's done so far in the season, is 255 average, 10 home runs, 35 RBIs. We'd like to see the RBIs be a little bit higher, but he did miss some time earlier this year with that kind of like oblique strain, which did kind of limit him for a little while as well. Once again, averaging under 10 fantasy points per game at $3,500. But if we look at what he's done as of late, 11 out of his last 14 games have had at least 1 hit. 6 multi-hit games during that time span, 4 home runs, 6 double-digit performances, and then he also does have 8 performances of at least 9 fantasy points. So offers a decently safe floor. If this game ultimately ends up going off, I do like him and his upside that he does have versus Aaron Nola, as we've seen time in and time out throughout his career. Then we move down to our outfield. We're going to start off with Julio Rodriguez. He's $2,700, which probably the cheapest price tag you're going to see on him all season. Obviously, he had the really slow start to the year, kind of heated up after that, slowed down, heated up, and then he was coming off a pretty downturn once again. Looks like he's kind of coming out of that as of late, though, so hopefully that's the case once again for him tonight. $2,700, averaging under 9 fantasy points per game on the season. He is 2-for-8 with one home run in his career versus Kevin Gausman, so there is some upside to be had there. He has at least one hit in 3 out of his last 4 games. Only one multi-hit game during that time span. He does have one home run, one double-digit performance, but he did have at least 2 games of 9 fantasy points during that 4-game stretch. So the upside is always going to be there with Julio Rodriguez just in general. I want to take advantage of him at this price tag because we're not going to see it too often this season. So if you don't like that, switch over to somebody else. But if you do, might as well take advantage of it while we still can. And on the season in totality, he's got 247 average, 8 home runs, 30 RBIs. And obviously, we know what Julio Rodriguez can do on any given night. He's got that pop. He's got that speed. So offers a combination of ways to ultimately pay off at this price tag of $2,700. And then last but not least, we're going to go to Nick Castellanos at $2,900, averaging just over 9 fantasy points per game on the season so far. And he's another guy that did have that really slow start to the season, kind of picked it up since then. But if you look at what he's done in his career versus Max Fried, the expected starting pitcher for the Atlanta Braves tonight, 4-for-8 with one home run, so some pretty decent history there. On a modest 6-game hitting streak as we do speak. 2 multi-hit games during that time span, only one home run though. Only 2 double-digit performances, although he does have 4 games of at least 9 fantasy points during that 6-game stretch as well. So when we're talking about a value play, $2,900, we're looking for at least that 9 fantasy points out of them. If we can get double digits, even better. Obviously, if Nick Castellanos goes out and hits a home run tonight, it's going to be a really good play for us overall. And definitely do like that upside just in general. If you look at what he's done so far on the season, 236 average, 12 home runs, 43 RBIs, really started to pick it up after that slow start to the season. So I definitely do like his upside tonight. Obviously, this is that game that does have the highest chance of rain for tonight. So obviously, if that game gets postponed, if it gets canceled, anything else like that, we will be swapping off of Austin Riley and Nick Castellanos just in general. But with that being said, if you go with these 5 players that I do currently have listed here, you have $12,800 remaining. $3,200 per player, so a decent amount of money remaining. Whether you want to pay up for another star player, whether you want to take a little bit more balanced approach, definitely a lot of ways that we can approach it on today's slate overall. It's a 12-game main slate, so there is a lot of room and opportunities if you want to get a little bit different, if you want to try out, test some different things, especially playing in some GPPs just in general. But with that being said, we'll get moved over to my cheat sheet and talk about my top GPP teams to stack for tonight's slate overall. So with that being said, these are the 4 teams that I do have listed here. Obviously, there's even more. If you go over to my notes on the Patreon page, there's probably about 8 teams that I do kind of have even below this as well. So the main 2 that I like tonight are going to be the Diamondbacks and the Padres. The Diamondbacks are going against Randy Vasquez. A lot of their players have hit him pretty well in the past, although it is a pretty limited sample size. Gabriel Moreno, Kettle Marte, Corbin Carroll, Eugenio Suarez, those are kind of like the 4 that really truly stand out in that regard, but you can definitely play anybody from this Diamondbacks lineup. Christian Walker has been extremely hot as of late, so I would definitely recommend playing him if you're going with that Diamondbacks stack just in general. And then on the opposite end of that game with the Padres, they've hit Slade Ciccone pretty well in the past. You know, whether you want to go to Jake Cronenworth, Luis Arraez, Jackson Merrill, a couple other guys here and there. Definitely a lot of ways that we can build out that stack for tonight overall. And then we move over to the Guardians and the Twins. So both these teams are going against pitchers that don't have too much starting experience. So for the Guardians, it's going to be Bivens tonight. There was some kind of expectation that Kyle Harrison might be back for tonight's game. Does not look like that's going to be the case now. When I was doing my research, did it for Harrison. So if you're on the Patreon, if you're on the notes page, just know that I'll be updating some of that after this video does come out, if it has not been done so already. And then for the Twins, they're going against Sean Dubin and the Houston bullpen tonight, essentially. So no real history there in the past, but definitely do like the upside of both these teams tonight. You know, if you're looking at it from a bigger perspective, maybe the Twins are a little bit more of that sneaky play tonight overall. And while I was doing my research, it was expected that Freddy Peralta would be starting for the Brewers today. He is not. He has really good history versus the Dodgers in the past. He ended up in the cheat sheet. That part will be updated, or I'll leave a note at the very least in the cheat sheet once this video is over and everything. But Aaron Savali is going to be starting for them tonight, so if you want to get to the Dodgers tonight versus Aaron Savali, definitely does make some sense there, as he's been pretty bad so far this year. But with that being said, that's what I do have in terms of the weather report, the core picks, and the top GPP stacks for tonight's slate overall. As always, if you have any questions related to MLB DFS, be sure to drop them down in the comments and I'll get back to you as quickly as possible. And then as I typically do with these pre-recorded videos, I'll be leaving all the notes and the updates throughout the day down in the comments, whether that is weather related, whether it's starting pitcher related, and then I'll also be listing all these starting lineups as they do get announced throughout the late afternoon and early evening. So definitely on the lookout for that, especially as we get closer to lock. But with that being said, if you are brand new to my channel, checking out for the very first time, or have yet to subscribe, please consider doing so. Definitely would appreciate it. Helps to build the community that we're trying to build here at Coach Craig Sports, which is one that's truly for you, the viewers, helping you with your DFS. Right now we have the MLB DFS Core Pick live stream, typically Monday through Friday. Obviously didn't have it this week because Monday and Thursday were kind of weird days. Tuesday and Wednesday have been sick, so it's just been kind of a mess a week overall. I'm doing this as a pre-recorded video today since I do have today off at my new job that I just started recently. That's why we switched over to live stream for those of you who have been following that. Definitely do appreciate that and being adaptable as everything's been kind of changing, you know, the last couple of weeks. And then I do put out my CFL DFS video typically on Wednesdays, so definitely be sure to check that out. One game down this week, but if you know you want to play a two-game slate, single-game slate, anything else like that, there is some information in there that will be very valuable as well. And then last but not least, if you're interested in sports betting, if you're interested in prop betting whatsoever, be sure to check out the links and promo codes down in the description below for Parlay Play, Prize Picks, and BetUS. If you're a brand new user on any one of those three sites, when you sign up, you make your initial deposit, you'll get a first match deposit bonus. For Parlay Play and Prize Picks, it's 100% match up to $100. And then for BetUS, it's 125% match, I believe, still up to $2,500. And I know that I've been mentioning this as of late. They do have it listed on their website now that is for the first three deposits. So definitely some pretty good opportunities to be had out there. If you have any other additional questions related to that whatsoever, feel free to reach out to me, whether it's down in the comments or on Twitter at Coach Craig Sport, and be more than happy to help you with that journey as well. But with that being said, that's all that I truly have for today's video. Definitely do appreciate each and every one of you tuning in. Definitely means a lot to me. I hope that each and every one of you have a great rest of your day and some pretty good luck in MLB DFS tonight.